time has slipped away, and suddenly it's hard to find the memories you left behind. Remember, do you remember?
I'll never do.
Magic carpet ride, a whole new world.
I was saying is I have really enjoyed this last month just learning a lot more about my family. And we've talked about little bits and pieces of the family as the years have gone on, but just this year we just kind of got everything together. And we kind of found out who's related to whom, what happened, when it happened. And I did a little summary in here. I just want to briefly go through this, that mother was born on May 18th, 1917, and dad was born on April 20th. April 20th of 1915, and obviously you can do the mathematics yourself. But from the family background, dad was the youngest of three brothers. Okay, mother was the youngest actually of three sisters and one brother. And also she had a half brother later time. Her father died when mother was 11 months old. Her mother died when she was 11 years old. And mother was always very tall. That hasn't changed. Had brilliant red hair, which she's always self-conscious about, and I thought was very beautiful myself. Second only to what she has right now, this more mature look that I like so much. And at age 15, my mother went and took her half-brother, Roland, and she went off to work. Okay, she completed the seventh grade at St. Bridget's, and she got a work permit because you couldn't work in those days until you were 16. She went to work at the Crown Morgan Seal in the cafeteria at one point. You started in the cafeteria. Started the factory and eventually went to the cafeteria. And she worked over there for a number of years. Okay, and later on in time, as time went on, mother actually went to work over what was then known as Baltimore City Hospital and became a patient aide over there. It was really quite a transition for her. And she really got this position by the good work she was doing over there at that particular time. And she was actually able to further her education while at Baltimore City Hospital. Okay, dad, on the other hand, he grew up at Sacred Heart's Parish. And father, he was the youngest of the three brothers. Okay, father is the only brother left at this particular time. And he also went to work at age 15. He went to work over at the broom factory. And at that time, this was in Canton. And at that time, dad was making 22 cents an hour. Things have changed a little bit now. But it's basically an East Baltimore background. Same business for mother and Sacred Hearts for father. Father grew up over in Bolden Street, 300 block, which is still a really neat community in Highland Town. It's one of those places that has those white marble steps, and they still keep looking very nice over there. Mother and father actually met when they were 22 and 20 years old, and they worked at a mailing place called the Park Pleasure Club. And there was a woman named Dorothy Dill, who was a mutual friend of theirs, who introduced the two of them. Mother was selling chances at the Pleasure Club, and father wanted to get a chance from her. He didn't have the 10 cents to pay for the chance, however, at least that's what he said. But he said, I'll have to come back, I have to get the chance from you now, I'll come back next Friday and pay you for that. So that was a good opening line, and things kind of went on from there. 8 months after they initially met, they were married on July 17th. And the reason they got married originally by the Justice of the Peace, and you actually have a copy of the wedding certificate here. A couple of things that were wrong with this. Number one, my mother's name, and she's very proud, her maiden name in particular is Teresa, not Teresa. And that was misspelled in here, it had the H in there, and she's really proud of her Kelly and her Irish. And I thought this was kind of unique, and in reviewing this, I found out Denline is spelled wrong too. So they may have an opportunity getting out of this relationship tonight. Maybe they never really have.
We don't want to care.
That's suspicious. And because they were very much in love, they did not at that particular time want to go through the requirements set down by the Catholic Church as far as getting married. That they chose to go off, get married by the Justice of the Peace, but they knew they weren't going to mess with my father's mother, Marie, who was a very stern woman, 5 feet 2 inches. And they decided that before they would tell her, they better get married Catholic. Now, I do want to imagine, I'm a fairly good-sized guy, I think. I was 10 pounds when I was born, good-sized person. Father was 13 pounds when he was born. Grandmother was 5 feet 2. The rumors are she never walked right again after having father. And I want to point out that my grandmother Marie, I think Frankie verified this, and really at that particular time the hub of our family. That was my 18th birthday. She passed on before my 18th birthday. And it was just nice to go over there. I always ran into Frankie over there and also my uncles. And it was just, that's where the family gathered. Mother loved being over there as well. And when she passed on, it really took away, I think, us being together as frequently as we did have so in the past. Well, now keep in mind, Mother's from St. Bridget's, Dad's from Sacred Hearts, and Mother likes to get her way in everything. And when she decided that she wanted to get married over at St. Patrick's, her mother was married to St. Patrick's, and she said, that's where I want to be. And I want to point out that this is Chuck Pollock's parish as well, too. And Chuck may or may not want to share with the St. Patrick story a little later on. But Chuck was saying he remembers the priest that married him, Monsignor Eckenbrugger. And the one thing he remembered about him, well, two things. He was very stern-looking and a big guy. Well, Monsignor Eckenbrugger said to Mother and Father, we're not going to marry her unless you get married in your own parish. And Mother said to him, look, she said, either you marry me here or I'm not going to get married Catholic. Needless to say, he married him. And that's pretty much the story of their marriage. Yeah, they had it was 9 years after they married that they had myself. My sister is 6 years younger than I. And that's pretty much all I wanted to cover. Okay, I just want to give you a little background about the family, how they got together, what they did prior to that. And this time we have a couple other people who are very close to the family who would like to add a few remarks to what I've said. Okay, and according to our agenda here, Diane, you are up.
I just want to take a few moments to express the love and affection that Perry and I have for you and Pop over the years. We've been more than just friends for many years. We've shared many of the same ideas and have shared a lot of good times and tender moments together.
The feeling is mutual.
I'll start from
here. This is Pauline, by the way. Pauline wasn't on the agenda, but Pauline does anything she wants. She looks good.
I would like to take a few moments to express the love and affection that Perry and I have shared with Tress and Tony over the years. We have been more than just friends for many years. We share many of the same ideas and have shared a lot of good times and tender moments together. Perry and I have come to realize that Tress and Tony are a very important part of our lives, and that good friends like them are very hard to find. We would like to thank them for all that they have done for us over the years, and hope that someday we can do the same for them. Perry and I wish you both the very best of everything and look forward to sharing many more anniversaries with you. May God's love bless you and your marriage for many years to come.
Your example of strength and stability. Boy. Strength has given me strength to weather the storms that come day by day. You two are the star by which we affix our, oh my God, sextant, our magnetic north, our lighthouse at our port of call, guiding, encouraging, strengthening, and giving us hope. Analogies for the type of commitment and courage that you've displayed in your 60 years of life together as husband and wife, friends and lovers, confidants and parents to us all is what every poet and songwriter based their lyrics on, as well as every listener to these love songs longed for in their heart. Everybody wants somebody to love. You two have found it in each other. And I am privileged to see this and be a part of this with you. Thank you. Thank you both for allowing me to share in your life and in your heart. And I'd like to thank God for you. It's by Him that He's given you the grace and provided you the strength through the years and shaped and molded you in His own perfect image, an image of love. Thank you.
Well, it's my pleasure to meet both of you this evening, and my wife and I, Marion, to be here. We can tell you a little story about St. Patrick's, a little different than yours. In 1963, when I was 20 and Marion was 16, we decided we were going to get married. And St. Patrick's was our parish, and we went to St. Patrick's and told the priest what we want to do, and they would not marry us because we were too young and we probably wouldn't make it. So Marianne is Italian, and so we went down to St. Leo's, and the priest at St. Leo's, the Palatine Fathers, had no problem. So we were married in 1963, and we'll be celebrating our anniversary in December the 1st of this year, 35 years. So we kind of made a little fib out of the priest at St. Patrick's. So I've met George through working at Providence Hospital. I'm the housekeeping director of Providence, and about 6 years ago, as George said, we met each other, and George is not like a vendor to me. He's like a personal friend, and we became good friends over the years. So back in when it was very cold, it was probably November or December, George and I talked about your anniversary, and I said, we'd be happy to come, and we'd like to get something very special for his parents. So I'd like to show this to you, and if I have your permission, I would like to read it. His Holiness John Paul I impacts his apostolic blessing to Anthony Joseph Denline and Elizabeth Teresa Kelly on the occasion of their 60th wedding anniversary, 1937, July 17th to 1997, at St. Patrick's Church, Baltimore, Maryland, and is signed, and the blessing is from our Holy Father. I hope you enjoy it. And I have to tell you a little funny story about the framing of the papal blessings. Those of you who are from East Baltimore probably remember the art shop on Monument Street, right off of Milton Avenue, that was built in the early 1900s by the Octavik family. And there was Albert Octavik, who his father brought the screen painting to Baltimore. All the screen painting that you saw in East Baltimore was mostly done by his father, Albert Octavik. And the framing was done by Bernie. Now, Bernie is still living. Well, this picture that of the Holy Father that's on the papal blessings, the Octavik family have framed many of these pictures. Well, when John Paul XXIII was John XXIII was Pope, Mr. Octavik wrote the Pope a letter. He said, "Would you please, when these papal blessings come to us, they're in a very tight tube, and they would always glue the picture of the Pope right on the papal blessing." Well, when you got ready to frame that, the picture was a mess because it was all creased, because it was tightly rolled, and Mr. Ocknovich wrote John the 23rd a letter, got a letter back from the Pope, and from then on the pictures were sent loose so they could be glued on by the framer.
Oh, that's wonderful.
Thank you very much.
Thank you.
Thank you, George.
I mean, there's no two of these are alike, and this is just outrageous. I've had so much fun having this for, is it 2 to 3 months now, Chuck?
Well, I received it from the Vatican, I think it was December the 12th.
And I just been utterly, I was supposed to wear it out, showing it off before I was able to give it to them. This is just, it's just a beautiful, beautiful piece over here. And Chuck, there's no words you can say how much I appreciate what you've done for my parents.
It's our pleasure, George.
Thank you, Ben.
Okay, at this time, I just want to tell you that I look forward to spending many more years with you and celebrating our next anniversary. Okay, mother and father, congratulations.
I love you.
Thank you, son.
Congratulations.
Congratulations. So I'm going to tell you, I'm just as proud to be your mother as you are to be my son, because I never had no problems with you. You always used a good life and chose your own education, and everything turned out fine. So thank you for your compliments, too.
Thank you, Mother. At this time, our dessert is going to be the wedding cake, and Mother and Father are going to cut that cake for us at this time.
Lenny Waldhauser and my wife Carol. It's a pleasure being here and sharing this with both of you. And we've enjoyed the pleasure of your son and your daughter over these years, and many happy returns to both of you.
It's a pleasure to be here celebrating for your 60th anniversary. George was our best man at our wedding. We were married 15 years ago, and we were thrilled to have him be such a strong part of our wedding and celebration, and it's wonderful to be a part of this celebration.
Best of luck to you, Mr. and Mrs. Stanline. It's been a pleasure knowing you all these years.
Pop, I just want you to know that you're just very special people to me. You always will be. I love you dearly, and I wish you many, many more happy years together.
All I can say is God bless you. I hope you have many more years of happy life. I know my wife wishes the same for you also. Thank you.
These wishes go out to you for your 60th wedding anniversary. You know how special you are to Perry and I, and we just wish you a lot of love and happiness. Thanks.
Tony, many more years.
Best of luck, Aunt Tress, and I always remember everything you have done for me when I was small. And this is for me, Pat.
It's Bob, Shirley's husband. Best of luck and good wishes, and hope you have many more happy years together.
Aunt Tress, this is Shirley. I love you, and I'm happy to be here today, and I never forgot how good you've been to me through the years.
Happy anniversary to you, Tony and Tress. You remember the time I was trying to play a guitar when you used to live on South Elwood Avenue?
Hello, Tress and Tony. Congratulations. Hope we can get into the poker games again.
I just want to say that it was a wonderful time. Your son did a great job. You should be very proud of him and also of your daughter. And I do still remember the times when I was a little kid and came over to your house and you ruled the roost, so to speak.
Happy 60th anniversary to both of you. I wish you luck in the future.
And I wish you many, many more years of wedded bliss. And thank you for inviting me.
I want to thank you for having me here. And I wish you a lot of love and you have it all in your son George, which I who I really love, and lots of luck to you both. God bless.
We want to wish you a very, very happy 60th anniversary and many, many more.
Go that, many, many more, and we were delighted to be here this evening. We really enjoyed it ourselves. Thank you.
It's been a lovely party. We've really enjoyed ourselves, and especially the table we're sitting at. Thank you for inviting us.
The best of the future for you, too. Thank you.
You've taken care of our daughter, and we really love you. Thank you so much. Happy anniversary.
Thanks for everything. Happy anniversary.
Nan and Mr. Tony, you've been a part of my life for many years, and I thank you for all of your good advice and guidance throughout the years. Happy anniversary.
I want to wish you a happy anniversary. And thank you for everything.
Thank me. Thank us for everything. How about my daughter? I love you. We love you, honey.
And Pop, you know I screwed my little speech up, but I really love you. And I appreciate what all you've done for me. Best of luck. Many more to come. I love you.
For giving me a wonderful life, and I really appreciate what you both did for me. Thank you, and I love you.
Congratulations. Happy anniversary.
Best luck and warmest wishes to you on your anniversary, and it was just marvelous. You have two great children. Thank you.
This has been a very special thing to all of us here, and we all wish you another 60 more years of happiness. Best wishes.
I would like to thank everyone here for being here for us today. I'm very happy, and so is Tony. And I'm glad that we could be together at this important time, and I hope we can be together again for some more important time. And thank my son for being here and his friends. And we also, gotta give you a kiss, he told me.
Nancy and I just like to wish Mother and Father a very happy 60th anniversary. Mother and Father, we love you.
And we wish you many more happy years of wedded bliss. Enjoy yourself. To the hill.
Bye-bye.
Good night, everybody.